Hello and welcome to Physics Friend. We're talking today about nuclear radiation, which is different from EM radiation. It's ionising. It's not like, we're not talking infrared, ultraviolet here. We're talking alpha, beta, gamma, the three first letters of the Greek alphabet. Alpha, beta, gamma. Three types of radiation which you need to learn, you need to know about them, you need to know how they affect you, how they don't affect you, where they come from and what they do and what they consist of. So let's start with, at the very beginning, a very good place to start, alpha. Alpha radiation is caused by alpha particles. Now, an alpha particle is a big, heavy particle. It's not heavy by our standards. You could probably lift one up, definitely could, because they're basically the nucleus of a helium atom. They consist of two protons and two neutrons. They're heavy relative to beta and gamma. Gamma is massless, it's just photon energy, electromagnetic energy. And beta particles are just electrons. So I say they're heavy relative to the other two, but they're not actually heavy, heavy. Now they travel the slowest out of the three, these alpha particles, because they are the biggest, the heaviest. When they do travel, because they're so big, they collide very, very easily. And when they do collide, they cause a lot of damage. They cause a lot of ionization. Out of the three, they are the most ionizing. Alpha particles are the most ionizing. What does that mean? Well, do you know what an ion is? No, not an iron, that's an iron. And I'm not talking about the element Fe, iron, I'm talking about an ion, which is the same word but without the R, which totally changes the word to make it mean an atom which has lost or gained an electron. Normally lost, which makes it positively charged. As we know, in an atom, bit of nuclear physics now, in an atom we always have, in a neutral atom, we always have an equal number of protons and electrons. Protons are positively charged, electrons are negatively charged. We always have equal numbers of each of them, which makes the whole atom as a whole neutral. In an ion, this atom has lost an electron, which means it's lost a negative charge. The net result of that is that it's positively charged. Makes sense, doesn't it? Good. Alpha radiation is highly ionizing. It interacts a lot with matter, which it does mean, however, that it stops very easily. A thin sheet of paper is going to stop alpha particles. It's going to stop alpha particles. So they're gonna hit a sheet of paper and they're gonna be absorbed, they're gonna be stopped. They're not gonna transmit, they're not gonna penetrate through that paper to cause any damage to anything on the other side of it. Let's talk about beta particles. Beta particles. Now, beta particles are electrons, that's it. They're high energy electrons. They are kind of in between alpha and gamma in their penetrability. As in, they will be stopped by, not by paper, but they'll be stopped by a thin sheet of metal or some aluminium. So a thin sheet of metal, some aluminium would stop these beta particles. Beta particles also are less ionizing than alpha radiation, but more ionizing than gamma radiation. So they're kind of, it's kind of in between the two. Finally then, gamma radiation is, if you look at the EM spectrum like this, you go right up the high frequency, low wavelength, short wavelength end, and you find gamma radiation. Gamma radiation is very, very high energy electromagnetic radiation, which means it's effectively energy carried in the form of photons, which can have an ionizing effect if you have a lot of it. It's very, very penetrating. It needs like a foot of lead or concrete at least to stop the gamma radiation. There's gamma radiation coming from the stars, although it's in very, very small amounts, so it's safe for us on the Earth. If you have a high amount of it in a hospital or something, then it can cause you damage. Gamma is the least ionizing, it's the most penetrating, and it's basically high energy electromagnetic radiation. I hope that summarised the three types of radiation for you. I'll do another video on things like half-life and background radiation, so you can look at those there. This is Physics Brent. Thanks for watching. You can subscribe there, and I'll see you next time.